Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss about a plant fiber, cotton. Yes, cotton is a widely used natural fiber. It is a widely used natural fiber. It is a soft fiber. Cotton is a soft fiber and it is found all around the seeds of a cotton fruit. Yes, it is found around the seeds of a cotton fruits. Cotton fruits are also known as cotton bolls. This cotton wool or the cotton plants are grown in fields. Yes, they are grown in fields and they are grown at places which have black soil and warm climate. Yes, black soil and warm climate is good for growing the cotton plant. In India, cotton plants are mainly cultivated in Gujarat, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Rajasthan, etc. So at that places which have the warm climate and black soil, they are the most suitable for the cultivation of cotton plants. When the cotton plants mature, after maturing, the fruits of the cotton plants burst open. The fruits of the cotton plants, which are about the size of a lemon. They are about the size of a lemon. After maturing, they burst open. And when they burst open, we can see the white cotton wool with the seeds. So it just looks like a field covered with snow, because white cotton wool along with black seeds. So when we have to use the cotton wool, so first of all we have to separate the seeds from the cotton wool, and the process through which the process of combing, we can separate the seeds from the cotton wool, and it is usually done by the hands, and that process is known as combing. So after the separation of the cotton wool from the seeds, through the process of combing, we can use this cotton wool to make the fibers by twisting together, and these fibers are further used for making yarn and fabric. We will discuss about jute fibers. Yes, jute is also a plant fiber and it is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Yes, jute fibers are obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Jute is mainly cultivated during rainy season. It is mainly cultivated during rainy season. It is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. And it is normally harvested when it is at the flowering stage. When the jute plants mature, when the flowers had grown up, then it is harvested, and the stem of the harvested plant, the stem of the harvested plant is immersed in water for 20 to 25 days. Yes, they are immersed in water for 20 to 25 days so that the stem rot. And after that, these rotted stems, in from these rot stems, the fibers are separated by hand. The fibers are separated by hand, and this complete process of strotting of the stem and the separation of fibers from the stem is known as ratting. It is known as ratting. So after the process of ratting, we will get the fibers of the jute plant. And these fibers are again twisted together to form the yarn. And through the process of weaving and knitting, this yarn is converted into fabric. So the jute, which is not so smooth fiber, it is used in making mattress, it is used in making gunny bags, okay, and some soft jute fibers are also used in making clothes. So after the cotton, jute is also most widely used plant fiber. Now we will discuss various scientific terms. So first of all, food. Food, it is a substance eaten by the living beings to get energy. Yes, the substance eaten by the living beings to get energy is known as food. And to prepare the food, we need some materials. These materials are known as ingredients. For example, boiled rice is a food. And to prepare the boiled rice, the rice and water are the ingredients. So, to prepare any food item, we need some materials that are known as ingredients. Now, edible parts. The parts of a plant which we can eat. The eatable parts of a plant are known as edible parts. For example, your fruits and vegetables. So, these are the edible parts of a plant. Now, next one is nectar. Nectar means sweet juices of flowers. Yes, sweet juices of flowers is known as nectar. Now, the next term is autotrophs. Autotrophs, green plants are autotrophs. Why? Because they can synthesize their own food themselves through the process of photosynthesis. So, any organism, any living organisms which can synthesize their own food themselves, like the green plants, they are the autotrophs. Now, our next term is sprouted seeds. Yes, sprouted seeds. The seeds in which a small white structure is growing out, it is known as the sprouted seed. So, a seed with a small white structure is known as sprouted seeds. And this sprouted seeds is good for our health. Now, apiculture. The science of learning of beekeeping. The science of learning beekeeping is known as apiculture. After that, we will discuss about herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. So, herbivores are those animals which eat only plants and plants product. Yes, like your cow is there, goat is there. So, those animals which feeds only, which depends only plants or plants products are known as herbivores. Carnivores are those animals which eats flesh of other animals. They are the carnivores, like your tiger, lion. These are the carnivores. Omnivores are those animals which feed on both. Yes, which depend on both plants as well as flesh of other animals. So, those animals which feeds on plants as well as flesh of other animals are known as omnivores, like your human beings, dog, cat. These are an example of omnivores. Now, the next term is deficiency diseases. Yes, deficiency disease, as the name indicates, a disease that occurs due to the lack of any nutrient over a long period of time. Yes, if there is any disease in our body due to the lack of a nutrients over a long period of time, that disease is known as deficiency disease, like your scurvy and beriberi. Scurvy is due to the deficiency of vitamin C in our body for a long time. Beriberi is due to the deficiency of vitamin B in our body for a long time. Okay, so disease that occur due to the deficiency of any nutrients in our body for a long time. Now, balanced diet, as the term indicates, that is balanced. So, diet that contains an adequate amount of all the nutrients along with water and roughage. So, a diet which contains all the nutrients in an adequate amount, like your carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals along with water and roughage, this diet is known as balanced diet. Now, next one is obesity. Obesity is a disease due to the more intake of fatty food, or the, you can say, oily food. If we will take the food which is rich in fats, if we will take the fried food, then we can anyone can lead it. Anyone can lead to the disease of obesity. So obesity is a disease that occurs due to the fatty, oily food. Roughage. Roughage is a fibrous matter. It is a fibrous matter present in the plant. It is a fibrous present in our food, which is not digested by our body. It is not digested by our body, but it is must, because it helps our body to get rid of the undigested food material. So roughage is a fibrous material which is present in our food and it is not digested by our body.